Testing, testing. Hey, are you all able to hear me? Loud and clear. Okay, that's great.
Thank you. Hi, guys. Sorry. Okay, now it's good. Okay, yeah, that's how was Desmond. Okay. Okay, okay. All right. Okay, I don't want to keep you guys waiting. Let's just start our webinar today, okay? You guys, if you have any question, you can stop me anytime you want. You can ask me along the presentation. If I have I try to answer the question as much as possible or as much as I can, okay? So today topic I'm going to talk about Fibonacci MasterCard, so expansion and projection. I believe last webinars I was teaching the Fibonacci retracement and extension. Okay, so today is gonna be last series for Fibonacci. Okay, so my name is Peggy, by the way. If anyone of you haven't know me, my name is Peggy. I'm an external trade analyst and working at Aver Fortune Group. We are partner with Digmill. We are finalists for best FX and equity in 2019, 20, and 21. Okay. Wait, disclaimer for sorry. Guys, so disclaimer, this webinar is just purely for educational only. If you guys want to trade, please do your own due diligence. All right. I believe Digmill will upload it on YouTube. Yeah, I think so. Okay. Okay. So the agenda for today, I'm going to talk about what are Fibonacci expansion, what are the rules for using Fibo expansion, and what are Fibo projection, and how do you plot Fibo projection in your chart? Okay. All right. So just recap. Okay. When you want to use Fibo retracement, or you want to use Fibo projection or expansion. So first you need to look for really clear market structures. It's like, you need to look for really clear move like this, either on uptrend or you go look for the downtrend. Okay, like this. It might have very, very clear move up or move down. Okay. And then you can identify the recent trend, which is probably going up or going down. And then you find the major swing high or swing low. Okay. And then how you draw Fibo retracement, that if on uptrend like this, this is just for a quick recap. All right. So for on uptrend like this, you're 100% here. You draw from this swing high to swing low. Support this is 50%, right? You wait for the price to retrace at this level, let's say 50%, and then you buy from this level. Okay. So always starting point 100% here, ending point is always zero. And we always draw Fibo retracement from your left to your right, like this, not draw from this to this, okay? Always from the left to the right. Any questions so far? Okay. So now, recap, okay? We were talking about retracement, which is from this level, 23.6% to 78.6%. This is Fibonacci retracement. And the last section, we were talking about extension as well. So today we're going to cover expansion, which is negative 27.2 and negative 61.8, which is, this is called Fibonacci expansion level. Okay, this is the one. Okay, how? This is, for example, for on uptrend, okay? Always on uptrend, 100% is always below, Okay, it's always starting point. Your ending point is always zero. Okay, and then you pull from here. You wait for the price to pull back at retracement level, for example, and then you buy. Okay, extension is always positive number here. We call extension. Okay, and then expansion is negative number, all right? Okay. This is, for example, on downtrend, okay? If on downtrend, your starting point 100% is always on top, and then your ending point 0 is always below. You draw Fibonacci from here, this point, to this point, okay? You wait for price to retrace between this level, okay? And then you sell. Any questions so far, guy? I just can check recording later. I believe they do upload on YouTube channel, but we can check it later. But so far, I think they do. Okay, Thickmill, they do upload in YouTube. Your two slides are showing different. Can you, which one? Do you see the different FIB retracement level? Yes or no? Okay, do you see I'm drawing A, capital A, on top, expansion? Okay, you have to, all right, guys, so you have to pay attention, okay? This one, expansion on top, because this is uptrend, okay? This is example for uptrend. I mentioned already uptrend. Uptrend always, starting point is always 100%, okay? Ending point is always 0%, which is you draw Fibonacci from starting point to ending point. You wait for the price to retrace or pull back at this level, and then you buy. This is, for example, on uptrend, meaning price keep going up like this on uptrend. That's why expansion is on top, okay? Here is downtrend, for example, on downtrend like this, keep coming down, okay? So your starting point is always on top, which is 100% here. Ending point is always below. We draw Fibonacci from your left to the right here, okay? Starting point, ending point, you wait for the price to pull back at this level, and then you sell. That's why your negative is below. Okay, don't get confused, guys. Okay, let me bring you to the live chart, okay? And then I think you can be more... where is my trading view? Just give me 1 second. Okay. For example, this one. For example, okay. Let's say this is on uptrend, right? For example, here on uptrend. Okay. Okay, here on uptrend, okay. You just ignore this pass, okay? Okay, on uptrend, we always draw Fibonacci 100% below here. Wait, okay, again. If you were to draw here to here, okay, you can see that this is your expansion. 61.8 by 6, my negative 61.8. Oops. Okay. You will to see from here, you will know that this is on uptrend. So we wait for the price to pull back and then you buy. Okay. That's why your expansion is on top. Your extension is below. Okay. This is on uptrend. Okay. Downtrend, for example, I will try to find example for you. Okay. Okay. For downtrend, for example, here, you draw from this 100% to lower 0%, right? Zero ending point. And you know that price is retraced at 50%, okay, from here to here, and then sell. And price come down. Okay, you see here? That's why your negative is below and your positive is up or extension, up, expansion below. Okay? So it's going up, going down in volume. So really low. Really? Can you guys hear me? Can you guys hear me? Can you guys hear me clearly now? Very clear, right? So far. Okay. Okay. Okay, good. So this is I answered the question, which is some of you guys asking me why expansion is up and the next slide, why expansion below. Okay, so this is example for a downtrend. Okay, so meaning price is gone, going up. Okay, like this. Okay. Okay, this is an example, which is I just mentioned. We wait for the price to pull back at this level and then we sell. Okay, how to make use of extension? Extension already, I think you guys can go back and watch the first series because I'm talking about Fibo retracement and extension. So today I just want to focus on expansion and projection first. Okay, if I have time, I will talk a little bit about extension. Set the sound steady high. Yeah, I think so far the sound is okay, right? Because a lot of you guys say they can hear me clearly. Yeah. And this, you know, my mic is already here. Okay. One hour. Okay, so the webinar usually hold like 1 hour. So we start like my time is 5:30. So you're gonna be in by 6:30 like that. So I'll keep on going high and low. Really? Okay. So far now it's okay. Mine is good and good. Okay, I just carry on. Okay, so what's our expansion? Okay, so actually expansion we use when we want to find support and resistance where it's not applicable if the price move through expansion level. For example, like we want to use expansion when we cannot find support and resistance level when you look on your left. Okay, so maybe I will bring you to the chart later. Okay, and second, let's say if you put a buy position or long position is open and then they occur or new high, for example, yeah, and then we will use Fibo expansion to predict where the price will stop or where the price is gonna move until, okay, it's the same at the short position or sell position. For example, let me show you. Okay, we are on the light chart now. Remove drawing, okay. Okay, for example, Maybe this one. Okay. For example, this is the, you see that on downtrend. Okay. Why? Because price is make lower high, higher low, right? Higher low. Yep. Okay. So from here, you use Fibonacci extension. Okay. No, wait. Let me by the example here. Okay. For example, from here, and then you want to put the from this one to this one, okay. You know that when price is break below ending point here, meaning price is really going down here, right? So this is the level you are looking at, which is negative 61.8 expansion for downtrend, okay. Okay, and negative 27.2 and 61.8%. This is the, you can put like your support level. This could be your first support and this could be second support. And then I will explain why. Okay, we use expansion when we cannot find the level, meaning when you look to your left and then when you pull like this, this is not a support level, right? And this is also not a support level. Okay, that's why we use a Fibonacci expansion to help you to get the level, like where the price is going to stop when it's broke. Ending point, which is your starting point here, ending point here. Okay. And then you see what going to happen. Okay, you can see that price is, for example, here. If you were to buy from here, and then it's my your like stop out. If let's say if you put your stop loss just like this. When you do like this, you cannot put stop loss here. You need to put stop loss below the wick. And then you don't get stop out here. So this is how you use a Fibonacci expansion. Yes, okay. Go back to the chart. Yes, like here. It's okay. We use expansion to find support and resistance. Like I say, if you look to your left, you cannot find support, any support or any resistance, you can use Fibonacci expansion to help you to predict that. You can see that I predict the target price. For uptrend or downtrend, same. Okay, you can use that, which is a withdraw for you in the chart later. Okay. Okay, for example, this is expansion. Okay, so the expansion we use two is Fibonacci retracement, and we only use, or I personally only use 61.8% and negative 27.2% expansion. And the tips, you need to look for the zigzag, which is starting point here, ending point. Okay, and then you pull, and then it retest 61.8%. Okay. Starting point, ending point, retest 50%. And then you can see that negative 27.2. I think this is my 27.2 here. And this is a key point. No, I don't think we share the slide. Yeah. But you can watch the YouTube, I think. Okay, so this is a key point. Okay, if you want to use Fibonacci expansion, the price have to retrace. You need to wait for the price to retrace at least 50% in point 3, and then you can use expansion. Okay, this is the key node. Okay, you have to wait for the price to retrace at least 50%, and then you can mark expansion at least 50%. It could be 50, 61, or 78.6%. That is okay. But if price is only retrace 38.2%, you cannot use expansion. Okay. So far, so good, right, guys? Okay. For expansion, you look for two starting point, ending point. Price have to retrace at least 50% or more, and then you can use expansion, which is negative 27.2 and negative 61.8. Okay. Okay. So let's find the example. Okay. This is the example one. Okay. You can see that this is my starting point. It's always on top because price is going on downtrend. Okay. Starting point, you pull starting point here. Any point which is zero. You wait for the price to retrace, which is on the retrace at 61.8. Okay. Since 61.8, you can just take a note at negative 27.2 and negative 61.8. Okay. So price likely will come to negative 27.2, which is expansion. And you can see here, starting point, ending point, price pull back and bounce off from negative 27.2 and then ending here. So let's say you know that price is already break this support level, so become overlap. So it become resistant. So this is support, after it's break, become resistant. So price is bow off from expansion here. If you were to buy from here, this is your TP. Okay, so this is your TP, which is at this level. Okay, guys. And you can see that we use expansion because when you look to your left, there is no level here. There is no support, or there is no overlap resistance or overlap support here. That's why we use expansion to help us predict where the price is gonna stop or revert from certain level. Okay. Okay, this is example two. Okay, so this is starting point here. No, starting should be two. Let me see. Okay, this is my starting point, starting point, ending point here, and then you can see that price is already retraced here more than 50%. On my, I think 50% should be around here, so this could be 68 or 78.2%, and then you can see that price is reject as negative 61.8. Okay, so this is on my uptrend. Okay, because price make higher high, okay, higher low. You can see that. That's why you pull starting point, ending point, and it's retrace here. I think 61.8 or 76.8%, and then you can see that price reject from negative 61.8%. Okay. Another example here, starting point, ending point, you pull from your left to the right like this, okay? And then you can see that price is retrace is almost 100%, which is more than 50%, which is, I think 50% should around here. And then you can see that price is bow off from negative 27.2, which is expansion. Okay. Any questions so far, guys? Okay. Don't worry, I will bring you to the chart later. Okay. Okay, one more expansion you can see. starting point, ending point, and price is retraced more than 50%, right? And then it stopped at negative 27.2. Okay. Okay. So now I'm going to start with projection. Any questions so far on expansion, guys? Before I move on to the next topic. What is the starting point? And this one? Starting point here, 100%. Ending point is 0%. Because, okay, you always draw Fibo like this, okay? Starting point, you have to draw like this. And you can see that price is retraced more than 50% already, okay? We predict. That's why we keep the eye on this level. I say at least more than 50%. I know anything about people I have to watch. Okay. Yeah. You need to watch Fibonacci retracement and extension first. Okay, let me bring you to the light chart here. Wait, where is my chart here? Okay, for example here, you can see that this is my starting point. Maybe I find the example, okay? Okay, for example, okay, I think if I, let me, give me like 1 minute, okay? For example, okay, for example, this, no, for example, let's say, maybe like this. Okay, I want to use a draw like this to this. I draw retracement from this one to this. Wait, the one is the where is my expansion is? I forgot. Let me see. My expansion on top. Okay. Okay. Or maybe I confuse, yeah, but let me see. Okay. So let's see, then probably have to go up, yeah. Let me find the example of this. I know what you mean, but I want to find the example for you because this one, you know, price going down. I want to see like price going up. Let me find expansion, for example, okay? Okay, for example here, maybe I can find the example later. Extension pattern, that's why I am here. Wait, let me read the question. How is 50 identified and count? 50%. Okay, when you draw the fibo, you already can see 50% here. Here is the 50%. It's already on a chart here. Extension, okay, extension I already teach you guys last webinar, okay? So extension is, this is extension level here, okay? If you guys really want to see, okay, I just, for example here, if you were to draw fibo from, I try to. Okay, wait. Maybe I pick from this, this one to this one. Okay, if I were to, okay, this one is for expansion. Let me find. Okay, this is an example of the extension here. Okay, so you see like this, you want to draw this is the fibo retracement, right? Okay, this is your starting point, your ending point, and this is your expansion. Extension, not expansion, this is your extension, okay? Which is, if you were to draw support and resistance, this is the level that you might need to like watch out, like this level. Okay, usually I use positive number, which is 127 and 61.8%, which is these two levels for my extension level. Okay, for the extension level, which is help you to find support or resistance level or help you to predict as well. This is your extension. Also, extension can help you to find the like TP, your take profit level. That's why we use extension. Okay, if you guys haven't watched, you need to go and watch extension and retracement because I already teach you guys there. For example, here, for example, okay, I use extension. If I were to buy from here, I use extension for my TP1. For example, this is my take profit. Okay, you can use extension for your TP, take profit. Could be your take profit one here. And this is my take profit too. Okay. And then you see price. Okay, this is my take profit already. Okay, you can use extension for your take profit level, or you can predict like where the price is heading up to when it break your starting point, which is 100%. Okay, guys, you get what I mean? If some of you guys haven't watched, you might be confused, okay? But if you guys already watch it and you still confused, you can go back and re-watch again. But if you don't know how to set the Fibo level, okay? This is I set my Fibo, okay, because I use Fibo retracement for expansion, retracement and extension, okay. So because here I don't have, so I need to move this one, and then I put -0.618. Okay, it's here, okay, and I think I miss out one over here, which is 1.618 extension. Okay, here. Okay, you can put out like that because 138.2, 11141, and 145. This is for like Elliott Wave, so I need to use put this. But if you want to only use extension, okay, for the extension and protection, which I really use, which is I use this one, and where is my 1.145? Okay. So this is the number I'm using, which is this is expansion. Okay. This is extension. This is your extension, okay? Okay, extension, retracement here. And then today I want to cover expansion, which is okay, expansion. This is expansion. Extension you can use for help you to predict your TP. TP1 or TP2, okay? I don't want to go too much in the detail because I need to cover one is projection, okay? But this is how you're going to, put in your Fibo retracement. And, okay, I'll show you again. This is how you put your number here. Just put the number that I tick, which is I always use this number. Okay. Okay, guys. You get what I mean, right? Yeah, always here, because on the chart, I will tell you expansion is always negative number, which is this one. Okay. I put here like this, expansion and projection, and I already mentioned this is on uptrend. Okay. You can understand what I mean, right? Okay. If not, I'm going to. Okay. This is the one I did live for you guys. I don't know whether you guys pay attention, but I already put it here like this. Okay. Okay. Let's just talk about projection now. Okay. Sorry, guys, if you think I'm not the best analyst for you guys, but I try to, you know, do my best and I will prepare everything for you guys to learn, okay? Yeah, but if you think that I'm not good enough, I'm so sorry about that, but I do my best. And everything I have written down here, unless if you guys just join in and you guys not pay attention, I'm so sorry about that, but I do my best, okay? Okay, let's just move on, guys. Let's just talk about our projection now, okay? So for projection, we are mainly used to get possible target level on going uptrend or downtrend. Okay, so projection, we are used 3 points, unlike retracement, which is only used 2 points. Okay, this is what I mean by projection. Okay, you can see that projection, we need to have 3 points, your starting point here, your ending point here. Okay, you draw from here to here, and then you want to project where the price is going to head to when the price is below your middle point here. Okay. This one, you get what I mean? So for projection, like I say, projection, I only use 61.8% and 78.6% and 100% projection. Okay. For these two numbers, only used for Elliott Wave only. And this is only like really weak one, but I use to just support my argument, like my TA or technical analysis only. Okay, so the main, based on my experience, I use this quite a lot. 61.8 projection, 78.6 projection, and 100% projection. Okay, and like there's a tip, you need to look for the zigzag, at least 3 points, and then you can draw projection, okay? Let me bring you to the chart here, and then you guys know what I'm talking about. Here, okay, so on TradingView, okay, on TradingView, we are use this one, okay? On TradingView, it's called FIP extension, okay? And we use retracement for expansion and extension, expansion and retracement, okay? How you draw projection, for example, we need to look for the zigzag first, right? So let me look for the zigzag. Okay, let me look for this. Can look for the zigzag one. 1, 2, 3. Okay, you can see this is projection 78.6%. Okay, this is my off-fib here, just to show you guys. Okay, I put like this, 61.8% and 78.6%, and one is 100% projection. Okay? Let me try to draw for you guys. Okay. Your first point, second point, your third point here. And for example, here you can see that price is hitting 100% projection here. Okay. This is how you draw projection. Let me go to like the recent chart one, for example, here. Okay. EU, let's just say I want to make my 1, 2, 3. Okay. So you can see that price is almost hitting 78.6% projection here. Okay. You can put this at your resistance if I do my TA. Okay. And then I want to find Fibo confluence, right? I draw retracement. Okay. And you can see that between 61.8%, which is this is retracement right here, and 61.8%. So this is the level. If I find like this, I will highlight like this, and this could be my retracement here, and I show 61.8% retracement and 61.8% projection. Okay. Okay, for Fibonacci, you can use for the higher time frame like H1 or H4, or you can go to the lower one, which is M15. If you are scalping or you are a scalper, you just use M15 to draw Fibo retracement or expansion or extension. I want to find the, okay, you can know what I'm talking about, okay. Like for example, for this one, I'm using Fibo retracement and Fibo projection. Okay, so I draw, when I draw already, I highlight here. Even though price reject go until here, but you can see that this is really, really important level because we have Fibo confluence here, 61.8% retracement and 61.8% projection. That's why price go up here, make a big rejection. This candle, and after that, they cannot prop to this level. This is how you use Fibo Nanchi confluence here. Oh, you mean projection? Okay. My Fibo projection, okay, easy for you to not get confused. Okay, when you see like this, 61.8, you just put like this as retracement, and you put 0.618, which is projection, okay? So when I draw projection, I'm using the FIB extension in TradingView, okay? When you want to draw 1, 2, and 3, okay, I show you how I put, this is my 61.8%, 100% projection and 78.6% projection. So I need only use these three levels for my projection to project where the price is going to stop or going to end. Not, but you need to have 3 points, yeah, for projection. You need to have 1, 2, 3 to project where the price is gonna heading to here. Okay. You can see 61.8. 78.6 and 100% projection. This is how I get or how you use this level. Okay. For example, I remove this. Okay. And I let's just say, okay, then let me put. This is my retracement. And this is how I get, okay. This is how I get the level, okay, 78.6%. And then I draw projection, okay, zigzag, 3 points, 1, 2, and 3, okay. How I, why I sell this level, because when you draw like this, right, 78.6% retracement. Okay, 78.6% retracement, and you get projection is 61.8% projection, which is this the one. Okay, I see you can put the middle. Okay, then you can see this the one. So I'm waiting to sell at this level. This is my, I'm waiting to sell at this level because this had Fibo confluence here, this level. Okay. Okay, now you see what's going to happen. Okay, this is where I get my entry point that day, which is 2nd of June. Okay, I sell from here. Okay, where is my TP? I use Fibo. I draw like this. I use retracement. I pull all Fibo. Okay, so my TP could be this one, which is first Fibonacci level, which is 23.6%. When I sell like this, right, and then I go and find where is my support, next support or next resistance. So this is my second support. Okay, I draw like this is my second support. This is very nice overlap support, and I highlight here my support level. This is how I do my TA. Okay. And then I show only the number that I think price is going to come, which is 23.6 and 61.8%. And this is could be my second support. Okay, I put here as my first support, sorry. And then I highlight just, okay, here. So this is my TP, first TP at first support here, my TP here. And this is my second TP, okay. People gonna either buy from here and buy from here. So this is how I do. I sell from here and then I wait, okay. I'm going to close at my first support, that is my TP, okay. And then you see, okay. You can see that price hits my TP, okay, first support, and then break below first support, and then it stop at second support, and then its price is revert up from here. If you were to know, this could be like M pattern, like almost M pattern, right? And then this is your neckline. You can say that it's neckline, whatever you want to call. Okay, this is how I use Fibonacci to trade. Okay, now you get what I mean. No, I don't use projection, the number that you mentioned, because I already say in the slide here. Okay, the circle one, which is I always using, okay, 168, just more to Elliott wave. If you know more about Elliott wave, and then you will know that. And 200%, you just look for the wave three over extension already. Like 127 also very weak, but I seldom see this. That's why I put like this. If you use Elliott wave, and then this is the level that you might need to look, but today we only do projection. So projection, I only use these three number only. Okay. This is the example. Okay, example here, like I say, starting point. Okay, now starting point, ending point, starting point, middle point, ending point here. So you like pull from here to here to project, which is 100% here. So when the price hits projection 100%, the price bounce up from here. Okay, this is how I think for your guide to have a better understanding. Let me just bring you guys to the chart. Okay, and then you will know what I'm talking about, or you know how I draw Fibonacci. Okay, because I use Fibonacci a lot, okay, every day. Let me show you guys, okay. For example, if I want to do gold, this is my gold, okay. And at that time here, let's just stop here, okay. I know that when I do my TA, okay, this is my first support. I do like this, okay, step by step. This is my second support, okay. Like this, okay. I make it small because I want to see how the market structure really clearly. So I kind of zoom in like this, okay. I draw Fibo retracement from this low to this high. Okay, and then you pull out all the FIB level, and you can see that I only show 50% and 60% Fibonacci level. Why? Because it line up with my support level here. I highlight like this, And this is my second support here. Okay. I take note like this. Okay. And after that, I want to use retracement. I use from this one to this row. I pull all. Okay, you can see that this is negative 22. Okay, I leave like this. I leave expansion like this. But when I pull like this, right, my starting point, ending point, and you can see that price is not retraced 50% here. Okay, it's only retraced 38%, which is this one due to be support, right? Now become resistant. So this is my first resistant. And I show this one at that time, yeah? I show at 38.2% like this. And then I highlight the key level. I change to red box. Okay, like this, right? Okay. And now, at the time, price is kind of ranging around here. Okay, so I pull my, if you were to draw from here to here, you know that around here, price is hit 78.6%. 61.8% retracement over here, right? If you were to use another like technique, 61.8%, and you know that Fibonacci is like the magic number. Okay, you can see that price hits 61.8% and then coming down. Okay, I pull all again. Okay, you can see that this is the first support is line up with my expansion, which is negative 27.2, right? So I show I can use because it's retraced more than 50% already. Am I correct? Okay, so let me show only negative 01 and I add up negative this. Okay, you can see that this is the level that I'm washed out, that if the price come to around this my buy zone, okay, my buy zone here, I'm going to buy because I have expansion which is negative 27.2, and then I have extension retracement, which is 50% here. So this is my buy zone here, the green color. Okay, so now you see what's going to happen. Boom. Okay, here is my entry here, 1931. Price is reverse about to 1925. Okay, my buy here, and then boom, hits my TP. Okay, this is how you use a Fibonacci retracement combined with expansion or projection. Okay, from here you also can use to draw this projection here. First point, second point, third point. But I think this one you may not see anything. Okay, so no, we're not gonna use this. But I think at that time I use from here to here. Okay, then project here 100% here. Okay, so like at the time I use, which is we haven't see this candle. Okay, we haven't see this candle. Okay, so I use a projection. Okay, 100% projection here. Again, I draw from 1, 2, 3, and then you get projection 100% here. And then you can see that this is 78.6%. Okay, you see 78.6% here, right? And then price is come down until 100% projection and shoot up here. So this level have three confluence for me, which is 78.6% projection, expansion to negative 27.2, and retracement 50% here. From here to here, okay? This is how you use Fibonacci combined together. Yep, guy. You guys understand so far, and I hope at least you guys or some of you guys learning something today. Okay, and this is how I use Fibonacci in my chart. Okay. Thank you guys. Thanks for giving me a thumbs up. Yeah, thanks. Okay. This is how you draw. Based on my experience, of course, I'm like you guys, okay? I don't know anything, same like one of you guys. Maybe you guys just maybe join, you may get confused. But if you practice every day, okay, you will get used to it, like you know how to draw. Because when I starting, I like from you guys zero, okay? I don't know how to draw. Okay, but if you practice every day, you will master it, trust me. Okay, for example, you don't know how to look, you can see like this. Okay. You can know this is your retracement. You can draw like this to here. And then I think this one should be 38 or 50% like this. Okay. You can see that between here, pi will you know retrace up about this level. And then from here, if you say you want to use a retracement, you can just pull here to here. Okay, then you pull out all on the level, like this, okay. Okay, so now price already moved, right? You want to know, you can draw Fibonacci from this one to this one. Okay, and then you can see that price is retraced about 50% this level. Why? And then you can see 50%, you draw, this is your first support, which is your overlap support here. That's why price is stopped somewhere around here. Oop. Okay, like around here. Okay, guys, so far, so good. So, I have one question. I just launched you know webinar, the poll. You can just help me read the webinars. You can give me one, I appreciate it. You know, okay. You want to give me one or two, appreciate your voting. Okay, so I can improve myself as well. So don't worry. But this is how you draw Fibonacci. This is retracement, okay, and if you want to use projection, let me try to, if you were to draw from here, you know that you can draw from here to here. Okay, this is, or you can move here to here in hit four, because this is already overlap support here. You can see, right? This is your overlap. This is your support as well, overlap support. You can see. This is retrace at 61.8%. Okay, you can draw something like this. Okay. Let me find the last example before I end the webinar, okay? Let's say you GBP. Okay, last one. You can see that when you draw, okay, from here, you can draw from here to here. And you can see that price retrace exact 50%. You show like this. Retracement 50% here, okay? And after that, this is your five. Okay, this is, you use Extension. Okay. For example, you were to buy from here. For example, if I draw like this, right? You buy, you were to buy from here. Your TP, if you really can hold, your first TP, of course, you are, this is your first TP, right? Because this is a resistance, right? Talk about this, but price all the way up hits your TP. This is your extension. Okay, this is how you use extension to project your take profit. Okay? This is how you draw. And TP already, you get TP already, right? So now you draw from this low to this high. You wait for the price to retrace, and then you know that price is retraced at 50%, which is, this is your demand zone. If you were to trade demand and supply, you know that this is demand zone. How you want to know the supply or demand? If you don't know how to look, you look at the light chart. This is your demand. This is your demand zone here. Okay, see? I tell you the tactic, okay? My strategy, you cannot find support and resistance. Easy. Support, always look for the V-shape. This is your support V-shape, okay? Capital A like this, resistance. Don't know how to find, you look at the light chart like this. Okay? And after that, you find, you just switch back to candle. And then you just adjust because the light chart, right? They only use the candle. But if you want to draw at the wick, and then you just switch to candle, and then you just adjust accordingly to you find the level. Okay. Okay, so okay, you guys, if you want to talk to me, okay, you can go to the Tick Mill Trader Club. Over here, okay. You scroll down. Okay, there is certain level here. You can join the club. Okay, you just follow the step here. You can come and talk to me. Draw the charts like this. This is my name here. Okay, if I find the opportunity. Okay, I will just give you guys something like this. I think I don't know why. Or if you have any idea, like, you know, whether you draw Fibo correctly or not, you can just, you know, talk to me over here. You can just join the Tick Mill Trader Club, and then you see what is just follow the step here, okay? And then I think they will add you to the club here, okay? That is, I don't know why it keep loading, but yeah, this something like this, and this is like description. I don't know why it's still loading here, but it's something like this. Okay, all right, guys, thank you so much for your time today. I really, really appreciate that. Okay, and yep, let me see. And I hope you guys learned something today. Okay. Let me. Okay. Yep. Let me go to GBP here. Yeah. So this is my name here. Like I say, if you join the club, you have any question, or you draw and support resistance already. Okay, you see, sometimes you draw, you can just link the object. So I know what you're talking about. Okay, pick your point here. And you can ask me like, Piggy, am I drawing the Fibonacci correct, which is 50%? I will just put like this, and I know which one you are talking about. Okay, if you already have the account with the Tick Mill, you can just add the support, and then, you know, you follow the step, and then you can just join the club, and then you let me know. Anything, you can just talk to me like, you know, hey. And then you can add like, because I cannot I think I cannot like talk to myself. But let's say just like hey, and then you just put like what is that? Like Peggy, for example, like Peggy, my name just come out here and you just talk to me here. Yeah. A lot of you guys are talking to me over this Thickmill Trader Cup as well. Okay. Guys, thank you so much, guys. Appreciate your time. Hope to see you guys again, maybe next webinar. Okay. Thank you, guys. Have a good day. Bye-bye.